Today we have with us Rijul Gupta, founder of Manseek, a mental health initiative.
Hi, I'm Rijul. So I started this mental health initiative called Manseek, and it mainly aims at raising awareness about mental health and also contributing to society in any way possible. So, yeah.
Okay, so before we get to the questions, I would like to give some stats. These are very shocking stats which we need to understand, like why mental health is such a big problem and we need to discuss about it. So around 42.5% of the people will go through some major mental health problem in their life, be it depression or anxiety. Around 8 lakh suicides happen every year around the globe, out of which around 17% are Indians. Talking about suicides, between the age groups of 13 to 17, this is the number one cause of death. And around 4.3% people at this moment are going through some major mental health problems. So this indicates like why it is very important to talk about mental health. And this is not just something jiske bare hum log abhi baat kar rahe hain after this recent unfortunate thing that happened, which has to be seen as a bigger picture.
Okay, so tell us something about your initiative, Manseek. Like, what inspired you to start it?
So, quite honestly, mental health is a personal topic for me as well. And apart from that, I feel that, you know, in India especially, that physical health is given more importance as compared to mental health. And, you know, there's still a lot of stigma created around it, no matter how many people know about it. So I feel that it needs to reach a much wider audience, and it needs to reach a lot more people in order for it to not be a stigma anymore, and in order for people to understand that it is quite an important topic and it needs to be spoken about and actually talked about. So I feel that by creating this platform, we can reach people and we can actually get conversations started, educate people about all of this.
Okay, so talking about mental health, what is the actual definition of being in a good mental health? Because there is a big difference between being stressed or anxious or being sad or depressed. So how can we know that there's an actual problem and we need to go about it?
So first, in regards to your first part of the question, I feel that also I would just like to say that I'm not a professional, and this is just my opinion on mental health and how much I have experienced or seen. So I feel that a good mental health could be described as, when a person is in a good state of mind throughout. Of course people have like ups and downs, but otherwise in a good state of mind, always feels good, or has a healthy mindset, and they have goals and everything is of course ups and downs again, as I said, but everything else is pretty much good. And I think I would differentiate when it comes to just if you say sadness and depression. So I think sadness is something that everybody experiences, and if we were kids, if we just got scolded by our parents or something, so you cry, you're sad for that moment. Then, or even as adults, if something happens, you fight with somebody, you're sad for the moment. But I think that depression is something much more serious than that. It's not just for the moment. It's not just a very short phase. It's a mental illness. And I think sadness is just a symptom of depression. And I think the way you can differentiate between the two is through all of this, right? Because if it's just for the moment, like in the moment you're feeling one particular negative feeling, then I think that would be something, you're just sad or you're just anxious for the moment. But if it's for a longer period of time, or it's much more serious or in depth than usual, then I think that could be described as a mental illness. But again, to be sure, if one is confused between the two, then they should definitely seek professional help, just as an opinion or a second opinion, to know if it is a mental illness or just a phase.
Got it. So I googled some symptoms of depression, and the things that showed up were like feeling lonely or feeling guilty or feeling worthless. But these are things that usually everyone will feel these things like in their lifetime. So like, when is it the right time to, seek professional medical help about your problems?
I think that if anybody feels that they're confused about it, a little bit of a doubt that, maybe I actually do have a serious problem instead of just me being sad about it, or me, feeling guilty or worthless for the moment, then I think, because obviously if you make a mistake or, you know, you feel guilty, but if you think there is, like, you know, if it's actually serious, even a moment of doubt, then I think that person should seek professional help just to confirm it. Because if you don't have it, then well and good, you know, you'll get better eventually. But if you do have something to worry about, then you'll get the treatment at the right time, you know, in the right way. So I feel that, yeah, when you're confused, or even I feel like the people around you, if they're also educated about mental health and they know about all of this, and they can probably, you know, understand that if you're acting different or you're feeling like if you're looking different and all that. So I think even they can sort of let you know that if there's something wrong. And I think that the person concerned should not really get offended by it, because they only care about you. So you should probably take their advice and go for it, because it's just one, you know, one appointment that you're going to, and you might get to know what's happening.
Got it. So the media often portrays people suffering from mental illness as dysfunctional members of society, or like they don't fit in. So what are your thoughts about that?
I feel that it's pretty inhumane to talk about people with mental illnesses as dysfunctional members of society, because, you know, everybody feels negatively or bad from time to time, and mental illness is just a prolonged, I would say, phase of that. I feel that by calling them dysfunctional members of society, that's degrading them as a person, when it's just that this is what they feel, right? By judging them, it's not going to help them, it's not going to help you. So I feel like instead of judging them by calling them this, we should be able to talk about it more and get them the help that they need. Whether it be your loved one or anybody you may know, even as an acquaintance, or somebody who's not that close to you, we should talk about it more, create conversations so that people can get to know how to go about it, and if they do need that help, how to get it.
So if someone we know, personally comes to us to talk about his or her mental illnesses or issues, so how as an individual can we help them?
I feel like the first and foremost thing is to listen, you know, above everything, just listen. Don't make any judgments. Be completely open to whatever they're saying, you know, because what you think about one particular thing may be different than what they're perceiving it as. So I feel like just listen to whatever they're thinking, what they're perceiving, what they're feeling, and just listen, and, you know, don't be confrontational about it. Because you may end up, you know, just making them like not talk about it actually by being confrontational about it. And maybe apart from all of this, choose not to go down the road of toxic positivity, because that honestly, I feel like that would make the person not want to talk to you, because your answer at the end is just that, oh, it's fine, it'll get better, you're doing fine, and you know, you'll get through it. Like, all of this is positive. Like, of course, support is required, right? So being supportive is definitely, you need it. But I think that toxic positivity is just going to, like, you know, tell the person that, you know, don't talk to this person about it. They're not going to understand what you're saying. So be supportive, listen to them, but don't be too, like, again, don't be toxic positive.
Okay, so a lot of times, like, this has happened to me when someone came to me and, like, told that I'm, you know, having some problem, like, be it anxiety or depression. But, like, I didn't know, like, how should I exactly go about it. I tried my best, you know, give them the advices. But, like, what we generally hear is, like, subah utho, exercise karo, sab kuch theek se karo, it is nothing, apne aap chale jayega. But, like, that is not how it is. We all know that it is very different from that. So what do you have to say about it?
I think the person who's listening to the one with the problem, they can... First of all, as I said, listen, you know, more than anything, just listen, because I feel like a major part of your job as a loved one is done when you listen, and instead of, you know, like, because what they want to do, like, I think a lot of people just want to vent out, you know, let all their feelings out. Like, if I'm talking to non-judgmental person, I can say anything, right? So I feel that just listen very carefully to what they're saying. And, you know, once you get to know what exactly they're dealing with, instead of advices like, you know, get up in the morning and exercise, or, you know, listen to music, or do this, do that, I feel like you'll be able to come up with actually substantial and, like, concrete advices, because, you know, you can research about those problems, you can research about those exact feelings that they're having, and you can... obviously, you won't be able to come up with a great solution, because, again, you're not a professional, but you might be able to help them in the extent that, you know, as much as you can do. So I feel that by listening and by hearing what their perspective is, because honestly something might not bother you, right? Like something that's bothering them or is making them anxious or is making them depressed may not bother you at all. Like it might make you a little sad, but it might not bother you at all. But for them, it might be an earth-shattering thing. I'm sorry. I feel that just by listening to them, you can, you know, get to know exactly what they're feeling and just help them by researching and, hearing their side of it.
Also, like, it is very important to understand that if someone is feeling depressed or, like, we cannot say feeling depressed. If someone is depressed or he has anxiety, that we cannot associate with something that happened. What people generally do is that, why are you feeling depressed? Like, you have all the things that you need in your life. But this is something which also has a lot to do with your neurological and your hormonal changes inside. So it is very important to understand exactly what it is.
Yeah, definitely. Because I've seen people who say that, you know, like, I'm feeling anxious and, it's not like, of course, you can feel anxious about a certain thing, but having anxiety disorder is something completely different. It's like, you could be feeling anxiety, like, if you have anxiety disorder, you could be feeling, anxious about something very, like, random, like, you can't even make sense of it. So, I feel that, yeah, you're right, like, you know, these are some things you can't exactly explain, but I feel like if you have somebody to talk to, then it helps a little. If not a lot, then it helps a little, at least.
Suicide committed by celebrities or public figure causes a big uproar in the value and awareness of mental health. But we also see that it dies down with time and people soon forget about it. So how can we change that?
I don't necessarily know how we can change that because this is not, you know, like it's not exactly one person job. But I feel that the more we talk about it, like separately and as well as when these unfortunate incidents happen. The more we talk about it, just, you know, like one-on-one or just in your friend group or posting on social media, I feel like even these things can make a huge impact, because at the end of the day, you're spreading the topic about mental health or mental illness through people, and it's bound to, people are going to eventually understand it, learn about it and get educated about it. Of course, if everybody does do it. So I feel that this is not something that can change overnight, that, you know, like, of course, there's a lot of hype created when it starts or when something bad happens and then it dies down. But again, if we maintain this conversation, if we keep talking about it, if we keep speaking up about it, I feel that then there'll be constant talk about this throughout, whether there's something happening or whether there's not.
Yeah. So a large part in an individual's recovery from the downward spiral of mental health issues depends on how the people around him or her react to it. But you can see that people in India still find the concept of mental illness foreign. So how do you think this problem can be tackled?
Again, I think that people need to be educated on the topic, you know, because a lot of people, especially in the rural areas, don't know what it is, what causes it or how to treat it and everything. Or, you know, they don't even know if it exists, to be honest. So I feel that people need to be educated. They need to learn. And for this, again, conversations need to be started. It needs to be talked about. People need to start speaking about it, not only on certain platforms, like particular ones, like, oh, this is a mental health platform, I'm speaking about it here, but everywhere, you know, in your daily conversations, talking about it really helps you maybe and other people as well, because then they also get inspired to talk about their own story or the struggles that they're going through. So I feel that the more you talk about it, the more it gets out there, and the more it's out there, the less the stigma is. And, you know, then people understand that there's nothing to be ashamed of. You know, it's just like if I break a bone, nobody says anything, right? You go to the hospital, you get better, people send you flowers or whatever. So I think it's more, just have start conversations. And I feel like eventually we'll get to that place one day that where everybody is aware of it and there's not a stigma around it anymore.
At least one fortunate thing is that at least our generation understands the importance of mental health and we know how to tackle things to some extent.
Yeah, I feel like that's a great positive, because like right now, the last generation, the one before us, didn't know much about it. So we weren't as educated about it when we were small or whatever. But now, of course, we have social media, which is there to educate us. And we have psychologists, which are like, there are a lot of psychologists out in India. Before, it used to be a big taboo, like, oh my God, like, why are you going to a psychologist? But now people are, you know, they're getting out of their shell and they're understanding that it's completely fine. And I feel that it's a great, especially for our next generation, that, you know, since we have such a great understanding of it, I feel that we'll be able to, educate our kids and, you know, then like so on and so forth, not just our friends and family, you know, like the next generation and everything. And I think that's a great thing because that's one, again, a big step closer to educating a lot of people.
Yeah. So, Rizul, you talked about rural India. So, like, what is the scenario of mental health in rural parts of India? Like, what are the, you know, obstacles that you face when it comes to, you know, talking about mental health in rural India?
So, I feel that a lot of people don't know about mental health there, that if it's like, you know, they may not think that it's important, or even, like, even if it's like an aspect to think about. So I feel like one thing is that they should definitely be educated about it, and they should learn that it's definitely there, and if you have a problem, it should be treated as soon as possible. And yeah, so I think, I mean, and if they do know, they may not have the means to get treatment. So I feel that the main thing is to educate them and to provide them services so that they can avail the services that are provided by, you know, maybe NGOs and everything.
So what are your future plans regarding Mansi? Where do you think it will go?
I think that right now we are, of course, spreading awareness all over our social media platforms. So that will definitely continue. And apart from that, of course, we'll continue having our lives and our webinars and everything, because I've seen that that gets a lot of reach. And apart from that, we're going to continue collaborating with NGOs. So we did collaborate with one, I think around Feb, called Sangati Foundation, where we helped. So we have a physical and mental health aspects. So we helped. So they have this particular service where they provide a service like psychologists through Skype calls to underprivileged people. So we help them, and we're going to continue that. And apart from that, we're going to, you know, after lockdown is over and after coronavirus is, of course, gone, we're going to try taking sessions in person with, you know, psychologists, and, you know, because that will definitely get people more like an in-depth knowledge about mental health and how, what to do. Like, basically all of this, like everything I've spoken about, but through the eyes of a psychologist, which is of course better. And apart from that, I would definitely like to get Mansik to a wider audience, so that again people in the rural area are also educated about it, because fine, like we know about it, but you know, there, I'm pretty sure there are a lot of people who still think that it doesn't exist, even like educated people who don't think that it matters as much. So I would definitely like to get it to a wider audience, and so that people can be educated and learn more about it.
So that's great. We will be linking down the handles of Mansik in the description. Do check them out and show them your support.
Yeah. So thank you so much for sharing about your wonderful initiative addressing the issue, growing issue of mental health. And this has been a very informative and insightful podcast. And we hope that Mansik and everyone associated with it does well in the future. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.